Hello and welcome to this Design Cuts video tutorial. Today we're looking at 5 time-saving hacks for Illustrator layers. As usual, I'm going to be using some Design Cuts stock in this video, so let's have a look and see what we're using. First off, I'm going to be using the Doodle Hearts clip art, so you'll get to see those Doodle Hearts. And I'm also using these 550 hand-drawn illustrations. There are files here suitable for Illustrator. They're vector files. You're going to be seeing some of those too. Sometimes when you're working in Illustrator, the color that is used for a selection is very close to the color that you're using to fill or stroke the selection itself. Well, you can change the color that is being used for a selection. These are applied on a layer by layer basis. We'll go to the layers palette and I'm going to select the entire layer here. And you'll see here the blue color that is being used to show us that selection. If I double click here in this open area of the layer, I'll open a layer options dialog, and from this I can select a different color. In this case, I'm going to select light red and click OK. And now the selection color is very different to the color of our art, making it easier to see what we have selected. When you need to create a stroked area around all the objects on a layer so that they're treated as a single object, so that these aren't treated as a cup with an outline and a jar with an outline, this is how you're going to do it. You're going to select the layer itself so that you have selected everything on that layer, and then go to the Appearance panel and add your stroke. Now in this case, I'm going to add a sort of creamy colored stroke. And I'm going to make the stroke really wide. But you can see that we've got some problems here because the stroke is being applied around each of the shapes and not the collection of shapes. Well, if we move the stroke underneath the contents here in the Appearance panel, we get the result that we want. We now have a stroke that is going all the way around the outside of these objects on this layer. Now, if you encounter a problem like this, it's very easy to fix. We'll just go into the stroke and we'll adjust the corner options, and this gives us a better result. When you're working with documents that have lots and lots of objects buried inside groups, it can be difficult to locate a single object. I'm going to click on this little shape in here and I want to find it inside my layers palette. With it selected, I'll go to the flyout menu and choose Locate Object. And Illustrator will open up the layers and open up the groups to show me the exact position of this object. Illustrator's default behavior when you copy layers between documents can be a little bit confusing. Let's see this at work. Here I've got 2 layers in this Doodle Hearts document. I've got just some of the hearts from that collection. They're in 2 layers. Outlines are in 1 layer, solids are in the other. When I select over these 4 shapes and copy them using Edit and then Copy and go to a brand new document and choose Edit Paste, you'll see that the pasted objects are now all inside a single layer. Now that may not be the behavior that you want, so let me just go and delete that. Let's go now to the flyout menu on the layers palette and choose Paste Remembers Layers. Now when we choose Edit and then Paste, the layers that we had in the original document, the outlines and solid layers, are being maintained as the objects are being copied into this new document. Now luckily you don't have to make that change before you select the objects and click Copy, you just need to make it before you click Paste. When you're working in a document that has lots of layers, sometimes you want to lock everything down except the layer that you're working on. So if we want to work on this wreath over here, we want to lock everything down so that they don't move. Holding the Alt or Option key as we click in this lock area automatically locks every other layer but leaves the one that we have chosen unlocked. Again, Alt Option toggles that on and off. So if we want to work on the watering can layer, Alt Option, click here, and everything else is locked, it is unlocked. Now, the same thing works for the visibility icon. So holding Alt or Option and clicking the visibility icon here turns off the visibility on all the other layers, leaving only the layer that you're working on visible. Alt or Option, click on it again and everything is visible. I hope you enjoyed learning these Illustrator tips. Let us know what you think in the comments below and give us a thumbs up if you enjoyed this tutorial. Until next time, I'm Helen Bradley for Design Cuts.